Hey guys, it's History Behind the Warrior, and welcome to another Soul Calibur 6 video. Now today I'm very happy to bring you all my reaction to the newest trailer that got revealed at 2 AM my time, for none other than Raphael. Now I do have to admit, I don't really have any expectations for this character, as he's never been someone that I've gone to in-game. However, I am extremely pleased that he at least is in the game, and fans can actually play with him once again. Because from my knowledge, although he may not be as popular as some of the other ones that are currently on the roster, he's definitely an individual that fans actually did enjoy playing. Now, I don't really know what to expect from this trailer here. I'm very intrigued if they're going to involve any of his vampire gimmick aspects into his gameplay, because for those of you who don't know, during the events of Soul Calibur 3, he's corrupted by Soul Edge's dark energy, and more or less does become a vampire. So I'm interested to see if this idea is kind of applied in his Soul Edge form, or are they just keeping Raphael human in this game? Now, of course, this is just an interesting idea I'm throwing out there, but I'm very intrigued to see what they do with him here. Now, I'm not going to say that I am surprised to see Raphael in this game, because for one, Soul Calibur 6 takes place just a bit before Soul Calibur 2, and of course, as many of you do know, 2.5 weeks ago there was a leak that had both Raphael and Cervantes on an early build of the game. So in a way, we were spoiled for last week's trailer and this week's trailer, and with the game only about 4 or so weeks away now, it looks like we're gonna have a trailer reveal every single week up until the game's out. So I'm very interested to see what they're gonna pull out of the hat here, especially if it's the rumored Huang and Lizard Man. Anyway, without any further ado, let's get right on to the reaction. Okay, so on to the final few trailers. Let's see what Raphael actually looks like in game. I haven't seen his portrait at all. Has he got glasses? It says Prelude to the Madness, which is what I mentioned about him turning into a vampire. So that's a little cool reference. Ooh, snazzy. Okay, so he's got that grab which I abuse all the time. Guard impact. That's pretty neat. Side grab. Okay, I noticed there's always a bunch of side grabs. Lethal hit in. That's pretty cool. Are we going to see another grab in a bit? So we've got Reversal Edge, which means you're going to get Soul Charge and... Okay, what does the Soul Charge exactly do? That's pretty cool. Alright, so is that a Soul Charge exclusive move? Okay, so Critical Edge. That's pretty cool, actually. I like that. Alright. I'm not too sure about the character design. It looks really weird. It looks not like he's wearing a mask, but more like he's wearing glasses. Nothing's wrong with that. Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. It's just a very odd and random design choice. I want to watch it again because I couldn't really tell too much from what was going on because these trailers are like so incredibly fast. But I want to watch it again and cut out any useless parts of this video so that way you guys can just get the highlights at this point. So yeah, those are totally glasses and his design... It's a mix between, it seems like it's a mix between his Soul Calibur 2 one and his third Soul Calibur one. Because if you look at the collar, he doesn't have the collar turned up until he becomes a vampire in the series. Alright, his super is pretty damn cool, I'm not gonna lie. The end half of it is what does it for me. The startup, not too keen on, but the ending's really cool. Raphael seems pretty cool. Like I said, he isn't the type of character that I personally go for, but I do quite like what's going on with him here. Anyway, I'm just quickly looking at his character portrait, and I can't help but feel like his portrait looks much better than his in-game look. Not that it's like super terrible by any means, but I don't know, I'm very mixed in the character design here. I mean, I dig the costume, it's pretty cool. I think it's just the eyepiece. I think the eyepiece is something I'm not quite used to in Raphael, and the fact it just kind of sits on his face is a little bit weird. But of course, that's not a deal breaker for me, and I'm literally just nitpicking at his design here. Now what does interest me of Raphael is what we saw from the Soul Charge. It was very brief. By entering your Soul Charge, you'll be able to have some moves that you normally wouldn't have in game. So obviously by activating it, you get a lot of benefits. But I'm very interested to see what else is going with Raphael here. Because I don't believe it's just mutually exclusive moves in a Soul Charge. It's not like that with really any character in game. A good example being Nightmare's Terror Charge, where a lot of his strings gain additional hits and he gets ridiculous chip damage. Zuslamel follows in a very similar suit, however he gains some exclusive moves from Abyss's moveset. So there's always a little bit more going on behind each different Soul Charge. Some of them work in different and weird ways, so I'm just interested to see what's going to go on with it here. That more or less wraps it up for this reaction. I do apologize if I do seem quite tired here. By the time I went to sleep it was 2 o'clock and then they revealed the Raphael trailer and I was like, first thing I'm gonna do when I get up is basically react to this. And here we are now and I'm still a little bit drowsy. Anyway, what are your thoughts on Raphael? Raphael, especially with his somewhat redesign. Are you sold on it? Will you be playing him? Please comment down below. And also, who do you think will be the final two characters revealed for the roster, as the game is more or less 4 weeks away? That's kind of it for this video, guys. Now, before it wraps up, if possible, let's try getting it to about 500 likes. It's a great way of helping out this channel since YouTube's ad system is broken as hell. So by giving it a thumbs up, it helps out a ton. And if you want to go that extra step, we also have a Patreon set up, and a link for it will be down in the description below. Anyway, guys, as always, please comment, like, subscribe, and share this video with everyone you know. Please take care, and I'll see you all next time.